Hello, and welcome to the next installment of TI Precision Labs. In this series, we will study a new amplifier architecture called the Fully-differential amplifier, or FDA for short. Before we get into the architecture and features of a fully-differential amplifier, let's first understand what a fully-differential signal is. A differential signal has two complementary outputs that are 180 degrees out of phase, as shown here. Each output is level shifted by an identical DC common mode voltage. The final differential output is obtained by taking the difference between each single-ended output. The differential output, therefore, has twice the magnitude of each single-ended output signal. Differential signaling has been commonly used in audio, data transmission, telephone systems, and high-speed data acquisition systems because of its inherent resistance to external noise sources. More recently, differential signaling is becoming increasingly popular in high-precision acquisition systems as more SAR and Delta Sigma ADCs adopt the differential input architecture. A differential signal has several advantages over its single-ended counterpart. Since a differential signal is a difference of two single-ended signals that are out of phase with each other, any common mode perturbation will affect both signals equally and will ideally be cancelled at the differential output. This rejection of common mode disturbances is one of the main advantages of the fully differential architecture. Even order harmonic distortion enjoys similar benefits to the common mode cancellation discussed previously. Hence, differential signaling tends to have improved THD performance compared to its single-ended counterparts. Yet another advantage of differential signaling is the increased dynamic range. As shown here, while each single-ended signal has a 2-volt peak-to-peak swing, the differential output swings by 4 volts peak-to-peak, thereby doubling the signal swing. This figure shows the standard pin connections on a fully differential amplifier, or FDA. There are two power supply pins, as well as two input pins, like a standard single-ended op-amp. An FDA has two differential output pins which produce the complementary outputs. The VOCM pin controls a secondary loop internal to the amplifier and sets the DC output common mode voltage of the FDA. An FDA may be configured to convert a single-ended input signal to a differential output as shown here in the lower left figure. This configuration is commonly used as the interface between a single-ended op-amp or a sensor and a differential ADC. An FDA is a symmetrical device, which implies that the source and ground connections shown here can be reversed without affecting the amplifier's functionality and performance. An FDA can also be configured as a differential in to differential out circuit, as shown in the lower right figure. The differential gain of the amplifier is set by the ratio of the feedback resistor RF and the gain resistor RG, while the common mode gain is set by a combination of VOCM and the feedback network. An FDA will be configured in a negative feedback loop as long as the feedback is between the input and output pins of opposite polarity. An FDA typically refers to an integrated amplifier. However, a fully differential amplifier can also be realized using discrete single-ended op-amps. Two different methods are presented here. The first method, shown in this figure, has the benefit of presenting a high input impedance to the previous driving stage. Amplifier 1 is configured as a buffer and drives both the non-inverting output as well as amplifier 2. amplifier 2, which is configured as an inverting amplifier, in turn drives the inverting output. There are a few disadvantages to this architecture. Since amplifier 1 drives amplifier 2, there is an inherent path difference between out plus and out minus. The phase difference between the two paths will result in a balance error that dilutes the benefits of the fully differential architecture, namely common mode rejection and improved even order harmonic distortion. In differential signaling, any common mode differences between the individual single-ended outputs will not be rejected and is converted into a differential output. In addition to the path difference, the two discrete amplifiers have inferior matching and symmetry compared to an integrated fully differential amplifier. Other things remaining the same, better matching and symmetry will always achieve superior common mode rejection and distortion performance. The output noise from the two amplifiers is given by the equation shown here. An integrated fully differential amplifier typically has better noise performance for the same quiescent power consumed by the two discrete amplifier architecture shown in this design. Another disadvantage is the lack of common mode voltage control. The common mode gain is fixed at 1 volt per volt in this configuration. A second method of realizing a fully differential amplifier using discrete single-ended op-amps is shown here. This amplifier configuration, unlike the previous one, can be used to convert both a single-ended input or a differential input to a differential output like a typical FDA. The amplifier has two independent feedback loops, a differential gain loop and a secondary common mode feedback loop. The forward path differential gain loop is realized by the two input amplifiers shown here, while the third amplifier is part of the common mode feedback loop, which allows the system to maintain the desired common mode output voltage similar to an integrated FDA. Both discrete amplifier architectures have significant drawbacks compared to the integrated solution, namely poorer matching, higher quiescent power per megahertz of bandwidth, and higher noise. Now that we have seen how a fully differential amplifier is implemented using discrete components, let's study the integrated design. Shown here is the internal block diagram of the THS4551, a high-precision FDA commonly used to drive SAR and Delta Sigma ADCs. At the core of the device is a differential high open loop gain forward path amplifier. Also integral to the design is a secondary error amplifier that controls the FDA's output common mode voltage. The error amplifier is typically a wide bandwidth, low noise, single-ended op-amp that works by detecting the average voltage at the forward amplifier's differential output and comparing it against the voltage at the VOCM pin. The integrated 5.2 kilo-ohm resistors detect the feed-forward amplifier's average output voltage, or in other words, its common mode voltage. The error amplifier then compares this average voltage against the DC voltage at its non-inverting pin and adjusts its output voltage. The error amplifier output subsequently drives an internal bias node in the feed-forward amplifier. An op-amp in a negative feedback loop will ideally have both inputs tracking each other. The negative feedback of the error amplifier therefore acts as a servo loop, adjusting the feed-forward amplifier's internal bias node until the voltage at its inverting pin is equal to VOCM. When the VOCM pin is left floating, the voltage at the error amplifier's non-inverting input defaults to mid-supply because of the internal 300 kilo-ohm resistive divider between the supplies. If the VOCM pin is left floating, a capacitor should be connected externally from the VOCM pin to ground to reduce the high frequency thermal noise contribution from the 300 kiloohm resistors. In case an application requires an output common mode that is different from mid-supply, drive the VOCM pin externally with a low output impedance DC source. A precision DAC or the VREF of an ADC is typically used for this purpose. The operation of a fully differential amplifier can be analyzed by following three golden rules. The first rule: the two input pins of an FDA track each other identically. This is analogous to the virtual ground concept of a single-ended op-amp. Note that both the DC and AC signal components will be equal. The next two rules are related to the FDA's output pins. Rule 2. The two single-ended outputs of the FDA are identical to each other in frequency and magnitude, but are 180 degrees out of phase, as shown here. The third and final rule is that the two single-ended outputs share the same DC common mode, or in other words, the instantaneous average of the two output signals is always equal to VOCM. For example, if VOCM is set to 2.5 volts and the voltage at Vout plus is at 3.5 volts, then the voltage at Vout minus should be 1.5 volts to satisfy rules 2 and 3 of the FDA. This concludes the introduction to fully differential amplifiers. Thank you for your time and attention. Please take the quiz to test your knowledge on the basic operating principles of FDAs.